Okay. Got it. Have you ever had anybody leave? Because that's an option. Just saying. Sorry.
Usually half the room is like, we're not on the record. Get out of here.
Yeah, I was kind of amused by that. So, good afternoon. Let's just whip through this roll. Valerie is here. Sandy's here. Julie. There you are. Hi, Julie. Angie Blackwell.
I'm here.
You're there. Valeria. Valeria's probably still out on. Allie Holsklaw. From Grand Ronde. Nope. How about Alyssa Severson from Coquel? Don't see her today. Deanie Smith. Diane Tiemann. No. Jennifer Jackson. I see you.
Yep, I'm here.
Christina Simpson from Coquel.
I'm here.
Excellent. Lloyd Commander. Don't see Lloyd. How about Michael Cherry? Okay, no Michael. How about Modesta Minthorn? No Modesta? How about Sonia Moody-Hurado? See Sonia.
I'm here.
And Alyssa Kane, excuse me, Alyssa Lane Kane from Celeste.
Here.
And then we have some open seats, open one from Cow Creek, open one from Burns Paiute, and open one from Klamath, just in case we were curious. So let's make sure we've got enough tribes represented to have a quorum. There's one, two, three, four, excuse me, one, two, three, four, five, six tribes represented. So six of nine, we have a quorum.
Okay.
Sandy, can you say who's missing again? I couldn't hear you.
Certainly. Allie Holsklaw from Grand Ronde. Alyssa Severson, I think it's Severson, from Coquel. Deanie Smith from Warm Springs. Diane Tiemann from Burns Paiute. Michael Cherry from Grand Ronde. Lloyd Commander from Umatilla. And Modesta from Umatilla. So no Umatilla reps in the room today.
So Umatilla is the only one that's missing somebody?
And Grand Ronde doesn't have an official rep unless, Angie, we've changed your status from Early Learning Council rep to a representative of the Grand Ronde tribe.
Not yet.
Okay, so Grand Ronde and Umatilla are not represented.
Thank you.
And Burns Paiute.
Oh, okay. I thought I heard you say three of them, but I wasn't sure. Thank you so much. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Thank you, Sandy. And from what I understand, we're going to go into the work session that we had and that you were going to give us a recap.
Yeah, just a real quick recap, because I believe that everybody in this room was in that room. So,
yeah, you want to do the, I could screen share, Sandy, if you want to do the recap, and then you guys could go into the breakout.
I was going to say, I actually printed off, I'm old school.
Okay.
I printed off your PowerPoint. Sorry. yeah.
Well, let me know if you still want me to
screen share. Okay. Yeah, please do so that the rest of us can see what's going on, please.
Okay, good.
So we met in Portland, had a great work session for a couple of days, and got a bunch of stuff accomplished. Primarily, we developed and approved a mission statement. We developed and approved our configuration and purpose for the organization. We approved that we do need that we need staff to help run this because we are now the Oregon Tribal Early Learning Alliance, better known as OTELA or Alliance, whatever works for you. We confirmed that we wanted to do a website to be able to push out our information and have it as a reach back point, a central point, a clearinghouse. I don't know, I could think of a lot of terms, but we wanted a website. And we talked about reportable metrics, got those figured out. Then we talked about our TAC funding, and we're still agreeing to push out the $139,000 distributed equally amongst the tribes in order to not miss that funding opportunity. We talked about the cost that would be associated with having a manager for our alliance, and then website and building a website and then maintaining a website. Talked about had some discussion around where those dollars could come from, whether we want to take it out of what we have now or wait until the 23-25 general funds.
Sandy, I think that was a question that Alyssa wanted to pose.
Is that why it's in italics? Is that why we're doing
that? Yeah, and it's highlighted. Okay. So Alyssa, okay. Did you want to add anything to that?
Yeah, sorry, Sandy. So I was checking in with our budget team and we're working with procurement. We've got the templates for the intergovernmental agreement so that no one's waiving their sovereignty for $139,000. So that's moving forward and we're getting the notice of funding awards ready so that you all can take those forward to your councils and governance chairs. One question that came up, so I was asked, we do have enough funds. One of the things we'll talk about later today is the kind of backbone discussion, and we have the money that we could absorb the attorney fees for that. We don't have funds for the website building and maintenance. So something to think about for next biennium is, would you want to pull from that? We're going to go from 601,000 in general fund to hopefully 629,000 because of the inflationary adjustment, hoping that that gets maintained through the legislative session. So would you want to kind of borrow from that in 23-25 to do the website build and maintenance, or is there some work you'd want to start now and adjust from the 139,000 in 21-23?
So that's something we should probably take to our group.
Yep, that'd be great.
Okay, cool. Refresh my memory on this next part, if somebody would please, in regards to the TAC, we are agreeing on the allowable uses of dollars, I'm assuming is what we're talking about.
Yes, so this is what we're trying to fold into the intergovernmental agreements, trying to stay broad so that you all don't necessarily have to do new work, although you're welcome to, recognizing that there's not a lot of time to spend it. So really making sure it could go to compensating your participation in this process, if that's the preferred approach.
Okay, so in this 130, so that I'm clear and then the rest of the group is clear. So on the 139,000 that we're working on those agreements and pushing out, that we have, there's several allowable uses for those dollars listed there. And I would assume that anything else that comes up in each individual tribe that differs from this would just require some contact with you and conversation and see.
Okay. Yeah, and we'd added that last bullet, early learning and childcare resources, so that if there were projects, I think someone had brought up like distributing resources and supplies, making sure that we have a broad kind of catchment for that, so that those types of uses would still be covered in this.
Everybody's good with that, if I'm not hearing any concerns or questions other than what we'll discuss in the breakout, which is that utilizing the general funds for the website debate. Maintenance. If not, I'm going to move forward. And not hearing any, could go ahead and move forward. So then we also worked on, because we had time and we did more than what we thought we were going to do, we worked on some governance structure so that we all had a clear understanding of how this would work in a government-to-government relationship and how the different governor's office and how the Department of Early Learning then works with us and the tribes and our tribal governments. So that's pretty clearly laid out in a fairly simple structure that doesn't look like a lot of different layers of hierarchy or governance there. As you can see, governor's office straight across to tribal governments, with the Early Learning Council being one of the bridges in between the Department of Early Learning and the our alliance. So, and then tribal affairs director under Alyssa and her crew, then on a direct line across with whomever we work to get to be our alliance manager. So if I'm not hearing any questions or discussion in regards to that, we will move forward. And then we talked about, discussed what we need, the work that still needs to be done, because there's always more work that needs to be done, right? So in this meeting, we were going to do some discussion in regards to the grievance structure, what that looks like. The discussion in Portland being that we're not really a mediator, that the Alliance is not a mediator, it's more of a facilitator in getting folks, our tribal providers and tribal entities, pointed in the right direction in regards to any kind of grievances or difficulties that they may have with licensing or operational issues. So that's the discussion we should have today. And then the Alliance as an entity, I believe that's a legal piece in regards to, and we were going to do some research or some to-dos on who could help us become a legal entity, as I recall.
Right, Sandy, and on that one, I left the month, the timing off of that one, just because we're kind of waiting and seeing once we get the information to kind of move that discussion forward. That's when I'll put in an actual date. We were targeting October, but Alyssa's still getting some of that information. So
that's going to be a little bit of an information gathering process, because it's probably fairly unique as far as entities are concerned. Yes, okay. Yeah, I wondered about that when we were in Portland, if that was going to be quite as easy as what we thought. And then in November, we need to talk about the metrics discussion about where that data is coming from, and really focusing on not duplicating tasks, right? If we're already drawing information to satisfy other grants or other requirements, then let's not reinvent the wheel. We can keep it the same. And then the website and the logo, again, discussions in November. So that is a recap of the work that we did in Portland, and looking forward to today's meeting and getting some more stuff accomplished as we move forward. Throwing your PowerPoint in the trash there, Jonas. It's done.
Don't worry, I have it saved digital.
Don't worry, Sandy, I got a digital copy. Of course you did. Hey, listen, I want to apologize to the group before we even get started, that I do need to bug out of here at 4 o'clock. I have a commitment at 4:30, so not being rude, but I just want to let you folks know that. Thank you, appreciate it.
Okay, and I'll pause the recording and then get the breakout session started.
So we discussed the rollout of the money and the contracts and such, and then the only question that we that most of us had was one of the main barriers on the reservation is transportation. Mm. What would that look like as far as purchasing a van, a bus,
That's a great question, Valerie. I can check in with our budget director. And it could be that the general funds might be able to be used that way, but you could use the federal funds. So I'll see if there's any limitations on that front.
Okay.
Yep. Yep.
And the other thing that we decided is that we would all like to take a smaller amount and get the website going.
Okay.
And the maintenance.
Okay, get that going now. All right. Thank you. I'll work with our procurement director and start getting that together. And then maybe at the November meeting, if not sooner, we can make sure the scope is right. I know November is what we flagged for the website discussion. So we'll make sure we can get something moving quickly.
Is there anything I missed, Sandy?
No, I took notes. I think we got it. Okay. Other than that, there was another general question in regards to the funds and we're worried or inquiring about whether or not we could use that for wages, right? Those dollars for wages. Mm-hmm. We assumed yes based upon some earlier conversations, but wanted to see you nod your head and say yes, Sandy, we can use those for wages. For a specific purpose, for example, say a social worker that was working in the Head Start program.
Got it. Yep, I believe so. I'll double check. What I'll check on is what reporting requirements you all would have, because I don't want to create more. I don't want you all to have to start tracking each penny. So I'll see what we can do to make it fairly broad so that it doesn't become that super detailed reporting. And again, I'll let you know if there's a difference between using the general fund versus the federal preschool development grant dollars. I'll chat our budget person during this meeting.
So one of the scenarios that brought up was that our Head Start is closed on Mondays. This leaves our folks without childcare on that day. Yeah. And so, you know, we were thinking about cultural Mondays and having something like that to presented for the children and the parents.
That's amazing. And that should definitely be covered, but I will make sure he's got that clear. And what we'll make sure is that kind of early learning and childcare resources section, that would be broad enough to kind of catch these pieces. Okay. Thank you for those. I'm going to send a Teams chat to our budget person. So if they've got an answer for us mid-meeting, I'll make sure to raise my hand and let you all know.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, next, Alyssa. I think we got everything documented from that discussion. But next on the agenda is just talking about the alliance manager role and then also the grievance process as a part of that.
Yeah, so if it's all right with folks, I thought we could do a high level overview. We've got some slides, but then maybe walk through the position descriptions themselves. I was just looking at them again today and I already see some things that would probably want to change just from what you all shared in September. And then we've asked Heather Thomas, who's here with us as our HR director, wanted her here to kind of listen in. She's not a classification expert, but to just give us a general sense of whether some changes would require us to get this reviewed and approved by DAS again, or if they would hopefully kind of fall within the already established scope, just so you all can get a sense of kind of timing and next steps on that front. So if that makes sense, I'm happy to pull those up and dig in. So we were going to start with what's been called the Tribal Affairs Manager. This is that Tribal Alliance position that you all talked about before. So Valeria's previous position, this is the high level kind of takeaway from the position description. Now that we have the Tribal Affairs Director, I think some of this might shift, but they are really responsible for the planning and implementation of the policies and programs across the agency that would support what is framed as mutual partnership with the 9 federally recognized tribes. So they would really be that main liaison and work to ensure the expansion of programs under the Student Success Act, Early Learning Account, and within the Office of Child Care to support the goals of the tribes that and respecting and promoting sovereignty. Focus on providing access and resources for tribes and tribal members who have concerns, questions, ideas, or suggestions about clusters and programs, and support effective policy for tribal relations, including writing policies and procedures. So this is sort of the overarching frame. And then I can share with you all kind of the weedier details of this, because I think some pieces seem to align with what you all had shared and others we might want to adjust. So the first bucket, 35% of the position, is really focused on supporting effective policy for tribal relations. So we've called out the early learning guidelines that have been, that are in need of revision, writing policies and procedures related to that work, developing guidelines and training for roles within the agency and within early care and education, professional learning, coaching, and implementing standards, some legislative coordination, and 20% being coordinating with ELD staff and tribal partners. So working with the government to government structure, designing and overseeing data collection, looking at managing special projects to support tribal relations. So leading the project development and implementation of projects, recommending budget projects and spending plans, and verifying project deliverables. So I read this and it doesn't quite sound like what you all had talked about in terms of someone that would really be focused on establishing the tribal alliance, focused on making sure that they could provide that technical assistance when it comes to applying for resources, being that sort of liaison to bring grievances and concerns forward. But that was sort of my reflection, and I wanted to hear what the TAC thinks in terms of, does this seem to meet the needs of what you're hoping this position will do, or do we need to really rewrite this together to be more reflective of that role? And I'm happy to send this out as well if folks kind of want to take some time with it, mark it up, and offer feedback that way.
Yeah. I would appreciate that.
I would appreciate that also.
Yep.
A deadline on it to return it.
Yep.
So that it doesn't hide in my email list for weeks.
Yes, we'll do that.
Okay. So you'll be sending it out today?
I will send that out.
Next couple of days? Okay.
Yep. Yep.
I think Angie has a question.
And when do you want it back?
I think if we could get it back by next Wednesday, so give folks about a week to kind of work through it. And if folks have any questions or want to see anything else, what I also might dig up is what Valeria's current job description is, so you all can see what the Tribal Affairs Director is scoped to do and kind of get the full sense of that office.
Okay.
Yeah, Alyssa, that actually was one of my questions. I was wondering, did you say that some of the things on the job description we were just looking at are actually things that probably would transition to Valeria's new role?
I think some of the roles like an advisor probably would transition a bit. I think we still want, I would imagine we'd still want this position to have, I mean, they need to have access to me to really promote that government to government relationship. And they need to be able to let me know when the alliance has needs or concerns, and especially through the grievance process. But I think making sure, because this position description was written before we received a tribal affairs director position. So I think we need to do some cleanup anyway between the two.
So Alyssa, I'm wondering, like, it would be great if you could send us both job descriptions, yep. But if you could even mark up the one we're talking about and say, you know, these things, I still envision having Valeria or the tribal affairs director do, so that we kind of have an idea. That would be really helpful to me.
Absolutely. Give a thumbs up.
And just remember in that, Alyssa, that there are things that, you know, maybe they'll still be involved in, but they move to more of that support role. So, you know, it might just be tweaking a little bit of language, but leaving the mention of certain things in there.
Okay. In that case, I will get these to you all tomorrow. I will make those edits tonight so that you can see kind of my thinking of what would shift. so that you all kind of have that picture. And please let me know if there are roles or responsibilities that you wouldn't want to see transfer, that you really want to see reinforced in this position as well.
Alyssa, which position? So just so that I understand, so we wouldn't be working with Valeria anymore. We would be working with this new position. So what would Valeria's role be, and who would she be meeting, or what work would she be responsible for?
That's a great question, Sonia. And I really actually would like the committee's perspective on this. I think while we're building an Office of Tribal Affairs, the committee seems like the place to really give us that guidance and direction of what you expect from the office as a whole. And I think through that process, we'll be able to figure out, you know, as you think, I know we talked a lot in September about, as the Office of Indian Education grew so quickly, the downside of that was losing that access to April, who's already, you know, 1 or 2 degrees away from Colt. So I really want to make sure that we're designing a structure that continues to promote and respect that government to government relationship, so that Valeria isn't completely out of the realm of the work if most of the work is going to be happening through the Alliance. And I want to make sure you all get the support you need, because it makes more sense for this Alliance manager to be the one helping you all apply for funds, bringing the grievance issues forward. And then Valeria may play a role in that, but the manager is going to be able to be more responsive, more in the weeds with you all. And then I think Valeria potentially could be really focused on the education cluster, but also really focusing on our agency and making sure that our processes are promoting that government to government relationship, and really training our staff and our teams, and establishing that process of work flowing through the office. Whereas the tribal affairs or the Alliance manager would likely be more focused on the Alliance itself. That's my initial thinking, but I really want to make sure that feels like the right plan and would make sure you all are getting what you need from us as an agency.
Well, and this may not be the place to bring it up. It may be in a government to government meeting, because not everyone is their tribal appointee, but I just hope we don't in all of this lose that direct contact with you at those government to government meetings.
Absolutely.
Okay, great.
No, yes,
April still comes and has her staff do updates, but she still is that liaison.
Yes. I still plan to attend all these committee meetings and the government to government education clusters, want to lift up, you know, Valeria, but also want to make sure you always can access me and get what you need.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for that question, Sonia. The other position that sits in this unit, that I wanted you all to be aware of, because I think when we talked this in September, you mentioned that no one had shared this position with you. So this is the Tribal Affairs Coordinator. So this is the administrative support position for the Office of Tribal Affairs. We'd had a failed recruitment, so this position is in recruitment right now. But they really will be responsible for a lot of what Gabby's been doing. So they would sort of be joining us to help run the logistics and technology of these meetings, support Cayuse and kind of capturing minutes and next steps and action items. If we meet in person, they would sort of attend to support. They would help you all if there's any questions about reimbursement, finances, and processing that. So they would really be the one to making sure that they're doing bill tracking, so that the tribal, that the Alliance manager, I have to keep changing it in my head, can get you all the latest information about what's happening in the legislative session, or if there's areas that you all might want to consider engaging in. So really that kind of go-between to make sure everybody is staying on top of all the work, especially heading into session, and would be another key partner in building that relationship with you all as representatives of the tribes, and ensuring that our Office of Tribal Affairs is sort of hitting the mark. So this position, I believe the recruitment closes in a couple of weeks. So this is another area that I'm happy to send the full position description. But if anybody would like to participate in the interviews of that, whether that's round one, or if you all want to be sort of the last interview round, really wanted to make sure you all had that opportunity. I'd apologize that you all weren't engaged at the front end when this position was created and recruited for.
It would be nice to have the notice sent out to the tribes in case there's somebody in the tribe that might be interested in applying for this position who doesn't normally look at the state site.
Thank you for that, Valerie.
Alyssa, and it would be really nice that if it is sent out to put if this is a position that could potentially be done teleworking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a great call out, Sonia. One of the challenges of this position is, you know, if we are meeting in Portland, we would need them to come to Portland. So we had made an offer and they resided in Cave Junction. They had some childcare limitations, so it just wouldn't work for them to staff, you know, full day meetings. But otherwise, this position will generally be hybrid, primarily remote. So we can definitely kind of explain some of those considerations when we distribute the recruitment. And since we don't have Valeria, I want to make sure I send this to the right place. Would it make sense to send the job posting to you all as the committee, or is there some, would you like us to work with LCIS, or is there someplace else that would be the right sort of direction to make folks aware of this recruitment and the other recruitments that are coming forward, particularly for the Office of Tribal Affairs?
I don't know if it's too much you know, bureaucracy to go through Patrick Flanagan and Adrian and have them send it to our CEO and administrative secretary, and then they figure out what they want to do with it, you know. But, you know, link yourself, you know, as you being the source, and you're the one that it's ending up with. But I don't know, like, if you want to acknowledge that, you know, legislative link or not. In this whole process, and but as far as like processing job descriptions and that kind of stuff, for us, it's got to go through our CEO, and then she'll do all tribal council and human resources and all that kind of stuff. So I don't know what anybody else wants to do, but
thanks, Andy. Happy to work with Patrick and Adrian to get this through, and I can make sure that happens today or tomorrow. Would folks here also like to see a copy of the recruitment posting so you can take a look at that, or would you prefer that we just stick with LCIS?
I can go ahead, and I think it would be good to send it to all of the folks here as well, and then we could share as we need to.
Perfect. Thank you. We will make that happen. So the other part of this topic, I know we're running short on time, was the grievance process. And so what we wanted to do was share the high level kind of structure, which again, I will send this full position description of the equity and civil rights specialist. So what we talked about in September was looking at what this position is responsible for, and are there some structures under this position that we could replicate within the Tribal Early Learning Alliance. So part of their job is going to be developing that structure, but they really are creating, they will be focused on providing consultation and technical assistance, whether that's through our child care resource and referral entities, with providers, some publicly funded programs, as well as families, and really making sure that they have an expertise in Title VI, as well as Section 504 and Title II. So making sure that they understand all protected classes and requirements through ADA as well, and as well as state discrimination laws. And then they'll also really be responsible for that investigation process. So assessing the complaints and then investigating internally or externally. And so again, happy to send folks, and I can pull it up, but you can see it gets pretty weedy really fast, what the position description includes. A lot of it is develop this. And so maybe a way forward is to make sure this position is talking with the TAC to think about that as they develop the system. But you can see 60% is really the actual work of facilitation, coordination, evaluation, and technical assistance. So looking at all of the discrimination laws relating to race, color, religion, national origin, age, or disability, making sure they're providing that consultation and technical assistance to our regional entities, looking at internal training opportunities for us as an agency and for our publicly funded programs, collaborating with leadership across the agency to make internal changes. 30% is actually handling the complaints and appeals related to Title VI, Section 504, and Title II. Reviewing and investigating complaints, leading or participating in the investigation of appeals, interviewing, preparing written reports, facilitating discussions. So this is a very technical and focused position that's really going to do that deep dive investigation work within kind of our jurisdiction. And so not sure if that's sort of what you all were thinking when we think of what the grievance process would be. Would it be sort of a parallel process within the Alliance? Would you want us to make sure that this position is also taking on grievances that are being raised with the tribes, or is it something completely different? So I can send this around. This position, I believe the recruitment has closed, but we haven't done interviews yet. So this is another place where if anybody would like to participate in those interviews, we would love to have your perspective in this process within the Chief of Staff unit separate from the Tribal Affairs Office.
Thank you, Alyssa. I don't really have anything to add to that. It would be interesting to see a copy of that. And I don't really know. I remember at the retreat or the planning session that we had that we kind of were grappling with the word grievance, and is that what we mean? You know what I mean? Is that what we're really talking about? So I think it's worth it to continue having a conversation about that.
Thanks for that reminder, Angie. Yeah, I'll make sure you all have this information so that you all can kind of figure out what is it that we need in the Tribal Alliance.
Yeah, Angie, and I'll document that as well as something that really needs to be defined by the TAC. So maybe the next breakout session, or maybe just another topic in one of these meetings, we could start to really define that. Okay.
Okay, thank you. If you could send that around, that would be wonderful to the same folks here. And I know that we've lost quorum if Christina has left too. So anything else would just, you know.
Yeah, all we have left on the agenda is DELC updates. So I don't think there's any like decisions that need to be made. Okay. So I guess I'll leave it up to you, Alyssa, if you want to just do something. Few updates, and then we could probably call it early since we lost quorum.
Valerie, do you want me to give some quick updates?
Yes, okay. It's information, you know, we can pass that on.
Great. So I think the two pieces, which I'm happy to repeat since I know we don't have quorum. So we reached out, and Gabby's been doing some digging with the Oregon Native American Chamber, as well as the Lewis and Clark kind of special law clerks. And so Gabby's been going through the resource library that they've established. And then Lewis and Clark has put us in connection with an attorney that could help us with this process. So a question for folks, we have the resources that we can absorb those attorney costs. And so we could enter into a small contract with that attorney, do a not to exceed amount, and kind of get their consultation. One question I had that maybe we send out in an email is, would anybody on the committee want to join me for those discussions? Or would you like me to just kind of report back what we're learning? And maybe it's, I can start it, and then at some point we'll need some TAC representation. It could be I could ask if they could join one of these committee meetings, but any guidance or preference for that process, if talking with an attorney is what folks would like to do. Angie.
I see no.
Valerie, we need your guidance on this. Do we want to invite them to come and talk to all of us at one time, or what? What is your thought on that?
My initial feeling was that, you know, if Alyssa does go and visit with them and bring back the information, I'm fine with that. Is everybody else good with that?
Thank you.
Awesome. And one question we'd gotten is if any of the tribes or any of you all work closely with the Office of Indian Education or the Oregon Indian Education Association. That was another resource that was suggested, which we're happy to follow up with them. But I wasn't sure if anybody here leverages those resources or that group at all.
Can you say their title one more time?
Oregon Indian Education Association. And Gabby, okay.
I think that at one time they used to be a pretty robust organization. And because of, I'm going to blame COVID on everything, right? But I think it's been waning a little bit. But I think I also hear that they're trying their best to get back up and start engaging and with one another and building membership again. Sonia, have you heard anything like that?
No, I'm not even sure who their current leadership is. I haven't. Even at the AIAN advisory committee, they didn't have a representative. They had Brandon that was prior vice, but I'm not sure who's involved.
Thank you.
Yeah. The last I heard was she's from the Tamara.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I can follow up with her. Thank you. And we're happy to check in with them as well if they have other guidance or direction. And we'll also follow up with the attorney and kind of see, make sure that's the right path as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then NEA itself is a 501c3, and Paul Lumley is the director of that.
I can reach out to Paul. Thanks for that, Valerie. Mm-hmm. Keep you all posted. Now this is going.
All right.
Perfect. The other piece I just wanted to mention, and I'll ask Angie if she wants to jump in, but the Early Learning Council is preparing to do the next version of their strategic plan. And there was not strong consultation with the development of it last time. And so we really wanted to make sure that the Tribal Advisory Committee was able to participate at the front end. And so the Early Learning Council just met this week to kind of kick off really that timeline and process, and did some initial reflections of what's worked well, what's missing. But I wasn't sure if the Tribal Advisory Committee would like us to bring some of that work at the next meeting. I know we've got a couple of agenda items, but I also don't want you all to kind of come in too late. So does that, Angie, anything you kind of want to add to that scope?
Thank you for reminding me, Alyssa. Yeah, so this is my third day with Alyssa, actually. The first 2 days were all day. Well, not yesterday, I guess. So the council spent a lot of time the last couple of days just reviewing what the first, Raise Up Oregon plan was and the goals around that and how much of it we've accomplished and how much of it we need to carry over. So it is a really good time since we're just starting up and that plan is just being developed. I think it would be great if we could put some time on our agenda for that so that we can have more input into making sure that what's important to us is also reflected in there. So thank you, Alyssa, for bringing that back up.
Yeah, of course.
I'm not sure, since we don't have quorum, if there's people that, would be interested in that, and it could be appointed from this council. But, if there are volunteers who want to go and listen in, I wouldn't be opposed to that.
We could work on kind of a write-up of, they have a timeline, so kind of what the different phases will be, and maybe send that out and see where folks would like to plug in versus having kind of a dedicated TAC meeting focused on the strategic planning. If that makes sense. Okay. Happy to work on it.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's it for my, I guess the last piece. I'm sure you all have started to hear this, but I wanted to acknowledge the background check delays. We just got 35 people trained up by the end of this week. We just got clearance on the IT front so that we have more people helping with the backlog of background checks. So if folks have questions or want to hang on and dig into the details of what's going on, I'm happy to cover that. But I wasn't sure if you've been hearing that from some providers and teachers and around the state, because we know it's been a problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have I have heard from Dini, who's not here with us today, that there are positions and it's affecting the grant budgets. And
yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so we're working. We unfortunately can't go back to the emergency background check process that we used during the pandemic because it requires a federal waiver that we'd actually requested last year and were denied. So we can't revert back to that, but we're staffing up and we're also looking at where we can find some efficiencies in our system. Because it's been very old and not scrutinized well enough, and making sure that we can make some process changes. But now that we have these staff, additional staff who've been trained, we have a pool of people that we can call on to step back in for the next wave that we anticipate to come in the spring. We'll see about 7,000 people across 3 months. They're up for renewal between April and June of next year. So that's going to be another big peak that we're going to try to head off instead of being stuck in the middle of it to help going forward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Alyssa, I know you mentioned it briefly earlier, but was there anything else you wanted to add about the IGA? Is there any timing update?
Thank you. So what I will do, Valerie, thank you for the guidance on the amounts. So we'll adjust the amounts and I'll get a note back out to everybody so you know what that kind of new dollar figure is, as well as the follow-up to the the funding use questions for folks. And then our procurement director is working with ODE to get those intergovernmental agreements drafted in the next week and get the notice of funding awards drafted, hopefully before that, so that you all can take those forward through your governance processes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Thanks for flagging that, Jonas.
Yeah, no problem. I think that was it for the updates, Valerie. So if there's no other questions or follow up on any of those, then we can move to closing.
Okay, so if I can I get Angie to close us out, please?
Sure thing. Thank you, Valerie. Creator, thank you for this opportunity to come together and to join hands to serve the children and families in our reservation and rural communities. I thank you for all of these people that are just so committed to bringing support to our families and raising up our children, for the staff and for all of the people that are here to support this work. I ask that you give everybody guidance and help them make the best decisions possible to help the people in their communities. Oh.
Thank you, everybody. This meeting's adjourned.
See you guys. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye. Have a good evening.